cop decides to pull out a gun on a child. Here's the video.
My wrist? I will let you record
your wrist. Yeah.
For what?
Ma'am.
What are you arresting me for?
Because here's the deal, okay? You didn't identify yourself.
Okay. I told you my name. I gave you my name, my first name, my last name, and my date of birth.
You failed to identify what state you're out of.
I have no idea
who you are.
I didn't understand your question. I said, what do you mean? I said, I work here. So obviously.
Please put your other hand behind your back.
Please call a cop. Call another cop right now. What are you doing? For what? I said who I was. I identified myself.
Look, don't come up on me.
Deadass, she's a child.
Well, tell her to get back in the car. Stop.
Call a cop right now.
Put your hand behind your back, please.
No, I identified myself.
Please put your hand behind your back.
No.
Ma'am.
You're trying to detain me for nothing. Get off of me.
Please put your hand behind your back.
I will not put my hands behind my back. No.
Put your hand behind your back.
No.
This man is out of control. Put up his picture full mask. North Carolina State Trooper Zachary Price decides to manhandle a mother, and you heard what he said. She says, why are you doing this? You failed to identify yourself. She says, I gave you my name and my information. Oh, you didn't tell me what state you were from. He said this. This is on the video. Is that an arrestable offense? No. Put the picture up again. Then when the child comes from the other side to see what is going on, he pulls out his gun. And you see how he pulls it out? Like he's a member of the Piru Bloods. Did you see how he pulled out the gun? See how he held it? As a matter of fact, a Piru gangster would never do that. Isn't that something? But this gangster did. On Twitter, one Twitter user may have identified the officer as North Carolina Trooper Zachary Price. One of the woman's daughters, her name is Ariana. Ariana posted the video on her TikTok account, but the video has since been taken down and reposted on the platform Reddit. The video caption for the original post read, and I quote, so today in Mount Olive, North Carolina, Officer Z Price pulled over my mother under the assumption that she did not have her seatbelt on. He then asked her for identification. She did not have her ID on her. After she gave him her full name and date of birth, he continued to rip my mom out of her vehicle and failed to tell her why she was being detained. After I stepped out of the vehicle to call my stepdad, he then pulled his weapon out on me and my younger sister. He did not have my mother in jail, and he claimed her to be an illegal immigrant, and they also stated that my mother lied about her name being Anna. The officer failed to read her the Miranda rights. He also did not have his body cam on and refused to bring a female officer to search her. This is actually very standard protocol for most police departments now, okay? Per the Angel Link page started to help raise funds, Ariana alleged her mother had been arrested for countless false accusations like refusing to provide identification and taken to jail. In an update today, Ariana stated her mother was released and anything donated will go towards a lawyer and legal fees, right? If you all would like to help, please do so. Please do so. This is not only sad, this is an expression of a cultural problem in policing. The reason why this happens primarily is because they are not held accountable as an industry, as an industry. I know some cops are, most cops are not, meaning the industry is not held responsible. To the 14-year-old, you are brave. Allow this moment, as horrible as it is, to spark something inside of you to transform the world around you. You have the power to do it. The experience that you and your family went through should have never happened. But maybe out of this, you become a great, great advocate, leader, and change maker, because you converted their evil energy into justice. All right, we will continue to follow this story. I have some additional follow-up to do with this police department. We will deal with this next week. Jessica, thoughts here?
Yeah, it's just obvious that he didn't pull his gun out because his life was threatened. He pulled his gun out because his ego was threatened, because this individual was not doing everything he asked. And that's a standard in policing. That's the culture of our policing today. There's no inclination there to keep people safe. He pulled her over because he thought she wasn't wearing a seatbelt and ends up trying to detain her, violating her rights. And it's really all about his ego. It's really sad.
Very sad. But when you have an industry that protects killers, it attracts people like this. The reality is, if policing was different as an industry, it would not attract the number of people who are this depraved.